Welcome back, everybody. Today we're going over the rifle that you see right here. This is the Sionics Patrol Rifle III. Now, I realize for a lot of you, Sionics, this is probably the first time you're hearing of that actual brand, but for some of you, you're very familiar with it. So we'll sort of break that down a little bit. Sionics has been around for a while. However, the overwhelming majority of the rifles that they've put out there over the years, at least from what I can tell anyway, have been for law enforcement departments and federal agencies and stuff like that. So they have developed a very good reputation in that community. And I mean, they're used by a ton of different law enforcement agencies and federal agencies out there in the United States. And they're also very well known on the forums because the sort of subject matter expert type folks out there are always recommending them, but they seem to not get a lot of play in different forms of, you know, media, social media, stuff like that. So hopefully this video changes that a little bit with my audience here. But what we're gonna do is just, of course, go over the rifle itself, all the details of it, because I think that really is one of the places I should say that Sionics differentiates themselves from other rifle manufacturers out there, particularly the AR manufacturers. They go a long way to choose the right parts, the mil-spec parts, the sort of mil-spec plus parts in certain cases where they're needed, to ensure that people who buy these rifles can depend on them. So that's what they say. So far shooting this rifle, that's what I've found, and we're going to get into some of that coming up next. But of course, first we're going to let the dogs take a look at it, and then after that we're going to go back out to the range and see what kind of groups we can get out of this barrel, then come back in and go over all those details.
Time for the accuracy portion of the video. We have a few different loads to run through the rifle. Just the setup here, target 100 yards down range. They are 1-inch squares, so that way you guys can get an approximation before I actually go measure them. We have obviously the Sionics rifle on there. We have the CTK Precision Rest here with a rear bag and Trigicon. This is a 2.5 to 10 AccuPoint, I believe, scope. Very good glass. I've been extremely impressed with it. And I think that's pretty much it. It's an American Defense mount. The first load up we're going to put through it is some 50 grain Federal American Eagle Varmint and Predator. It's a jacketed hollow point round. So we'll see what it'll actually do in this particular rifle. That load looks okay. Next up, we're gonna put some Freedom Munitions. This is their 69 grain hollow point boat tail load through there. New production stuff, tends to be pretty accurate, as those of you who watch the channel frequently know. Just so you guys know, Freedom does offer all the viewers here a 5% discount with the coupon code there in the bottom of your screen. So this is some heavier stuff, which it's the heaviest of the three we're about to test today. Just random choice of what we picked. And in theory, should be the most accurate, but we'll see. You never know. Again, as people who watch the channel know, what you expect on paper doesn't always happen in real life. And the last load we're gonna put through it is the 55 grain Sierra Blitzkrieg load from Guerrilla Ammunition. Stuff's very consistent load. So we shall see how it does. Go check them out. First up there with that American Eagle stuff, we're up here. Kind of an interesting note for you guys, just to discuss POI shift with different loads. Each one of these, I was aiming for the top left of the little highlighted square there. So top left, aim small, miss small kind of thing. It's zeroed for 193, so none of these loads. So you can kind of see how the POI shifted there with the different loads. We're right at 1 7/8 inches there with that American Eagle stuff. Then we came down with the 69 grain Freedom, tightened it up a little bit. Either way you measure it, right at 1 inch on the dot. And then up here with the Gorilla, right at 1 1/4 inches. So for having a lightweight profile barrel, and a mil-spec style trigger, which we'll get into a little bit more later on in the video. Those are very good groups. I will take those all day long.
We'll start out on the end and work our way back. We have the A2 Birdcage Flash Hider, which I'm a big fan of. For the money, you just can't beat it. And even for a lot more money, sometimes you can't beat it. It does a good job of hiding flash as well as reducing muzzle rise a little bit. So moving on back, we have the barrel, which along with the bolt carrier group is sort of the heart and soul of the AR-15 rifle. And this one here is their lightweight contour mid-length gas system barrel. They also offer a medium contour barrel for those of you guys that want a little bit more rigidity on there. It's chrome lined and it has a phosphate finish on the outside. It's got a 1 1/8 twist. It's 4150 mil spec steel. It is MP inspected, and you can see there it does have the M4 feed ramps as well. One thing that they do to it to ensure concentricity as well as straightness is they do air gauge it to make sure it's nice and straight and concentric all the way down, sort of an extra step that a lot of barrel manufacturers don't do, and as you guys saw out there, seems to shoot pretty well. Sionics went with the Centurion Arms M-Lock 13.5 inch handguard for the Patrol 3 rifle. I think that was a good choice overall for a few reasons. Number one, the lockup system here is excellent. The way it locks up, basically this pin right here, the center one, interfaces with the barrel nut, and it's virtually impossible without actually shearing that bolt right off that it would ever come off. Even if it comes loose, it has the little piece up here that interfaces with the upper receiver that makes it almost impossible to twist it. So really it's an extremely solid system, particularly for the weight of it. So it's a very lightweight rail overall, has M-lock sections on the 3, 6, and 9 o'clock positions, and it also has quick detach sling points here on the 3 and 9 o'clock positions, both up front and back here towards the receiver. You can see it has the holes, of course, to lighten it up and also allow for a little bit better cooling. Same here on top, just reduces a little bit of weight across the top, but still has that 1913 rail if you want to mount any lights, lasers, anything like that on top. Underneath the handguard, we have our low profile gas block. It is a 6.25 incher, so very lightweight. And one thing that you're going to notice here looking at these pictures is that it is not pinned. However, Sionics is kind of known for their dimpling system. You can see how one of the set screws is pretty deep in there, and you can see the photos there of how they actually dimple the barrel. So that's how they do it to make sure it's very secure. Of course, they put a locking substance on there. I'm not sure if it's red Loctite or some other type of rock set or anything like that, but it is on there. They are absolutely solid in there, and you can see it is very deeply set, so that way it should prevent any possibility of it ever coming forward. Of course, it is steel. One trend in the AR industry, particularly on low-end rifles, is to go with aluminum. I do not recommend that at all. I've seen some pretty bad issues with them. And then up top, we do have what appears to be a melanite-coated gas tube on there. So those things are really good and really highly regarded for being able to handle really high heat. So if you guys have ever watched the Iraq Veteran 888 AR meltdown video, his gas tube outlasted the barrel on that one. So and he was using one with that treatment on there, so pretty good testament to it. The upper receiver here is made of 7075 T6 aluminum. It does have the mil-spec type 3 hard anodizing on there. M4 feeder amps, like we talked about, has the T marking there on top. And one thing I should point out is that the Patrol Rifle 3 comes with the MBUS Pros on there. I've just been using the Troys on here just to sort of test them out and see what I think of them overall. But when you purchase one from Sionics, it will come with the MBUS Pros on there. So sort of look the other way on that one. I apologize for that during the review. But it basically is a mil-spec upper receiver in every way. It has a dry film lubricant on the inside. And really haven't had any issues with it at all, as you'd expect from the upper. Getting into the bolt carrier group, the carrier itself is made from 8620 steel. It does have the M16 full auto profile here on the rear that you guys can see. The gas key itself is made from tool steel with grade 8 fasteners on there. Again, right along with a mil spec, you can see it has very good, very even staking over there. It doesn't look like it was done by hand. It looks like they actually have a machine on there that's doing these with precision. So that's certainly a good thing there. It's very exact, if you will. It is NP3 coated, as is the rest of the bolt carrier group. We should get into that, the NP3 versus NIB and some of the other coatings out there. So my experience, all of them do seem to work and work just fine. But versus NIB or nickel boron, that does seem to have issues flaking in some instances. And this with MP3, I have a few different bolt carrier groups that are finished like that. I've never had that happen to any of them. It also seems to wear a little bit better. This one here has about 800 rounds through it. You guys can see it looks extremely good for the wear and tear that it does have on it. It of course helps to with cleaning, rather. It sort of wipes clean in most cases. Of course, the tail you're still gonna have to work at, like always with the AR-15, but it does seem to be a good low friction coating on there, and a lot of people I know are gonna like it. So moving on to the bolt, it is made of Carpenter 158 steel. It is HP and MP tested individually. It is shop peened. Has, again, we have a tool steel extractor here, and this one here has the black insert and the Springco 5-coil heavy extractor springs. So what does that mean, right, for a lot of new folks out there? So along the development of the M4, they went to the O-ring on there, and then they found some issues with basically operating in cold weather and some other things, and they went with the black insert. It was noted as the Colt insert in some places, and then the Colt spring. Springco has basically duplicated that with their efforts, and some folks actually think the Springco is a little bit better, and that's what we have in here. So a lot of people out there, particularly in semi-auto mid-length gas system rifles, think that this is the optimum setup. I can't disagree with them. I've never had an issue with that type of setup. It seems to work just fine, and of course you can see the finish there applied evenly throughout the bolt. And overall, pretty good system and has excellent specs. And that's really what you're looking for with the bolt carrier group. The charging handle that comes with the rifle is forged 7075 T6 aluminum, mil-spec stuff, so nothing fancy, but certainly a proven commodity. And I know some of the ones out there on some lesser-priced rifles aren't going to be forged, and some of them are made of 6061 as well. So mil-spec stuff there, nothing to complain about at all. The lower receiver itself is made of 7075 T6 aluminum, Type 3 hard anodized, according to mil-spec, just like the upper receiver is. We do have the MagPul trigger guard on there, and it's going to give you a little bit more room whether or not you're shooting out in the winter with gloved hands, or just in general, it's not going to scrape the bottom of your finger, which I certainly appreciate. We do have the MagPul K2 grip on there. I do like that one a lot. I think I have a standalone review of it. I'm a big fan of it. The lower receiver does have a slight flare to the magwell, which I like. If they flared it a little bit more, I wouldn't be opposed to it, but having it there certainly is a good thing. We do have a safety lever, I should say, that does come factory like that. All of them will come with that, and the trigger on the rifle is the Sionics enhanced trigger. So enhanced mil-spec trigger. It's got mil-spec dimensions, but it does have the nickel coating on there to reduce friction. And the pull weight on mine is right at 5.5 pounds pretty consistently, just about every pull. And I'm not sure if I mentioned it during the accuracy test, so I'll just repeat it if I did. The pull, very clean, like a mil-spec, not a lot of travel like you expect. But the reset has a really, really positive spring pushing it forward, and that is one thing that they do spec out over there at Sionics. Another nice thing about the trigger is that as it comes from the factory, it does have grease applied on all the contact points. Small thing, but in a lot of rifles, that the small things are what matters. So continuing to move on back, we have the Magpul QD end plate there, which I do like. It's nice and low profile, works well. We have an H buffer in there. It is a tungsten weighted buffer, and then it has the Springco white spring in there. So that, I believe, is the 17 pound spring. And as you see here with our castle nut, it is staked in two positions pretty aggressively. The buffer tube itself is going to be 7075 T6 mil spec dimension, and it does also have the dry film lubricant in there, just like the upper receiver. It has a six position adjustable buffer tube. And then we have back here our Magpul SL stock. Great stock. I think I have a actual dedicated review to it. Big fan of it. It's ergonomic. It has a little bit more cheek weld, if you will, than your standard mil-spec style stock, which is a little bit more comfortable, but it's not overly large, nice and lightweight, and has a nice toe here, so that way if you're just either rolling the rifle up to your shoulder or wearing it with body armor, very comfortable to shoot. A couple points to hit on that we didn't cover so far is number one is going to be weight. I know folks are always going to be asking me about that with the AR. So with the iron sights that you see on here, this rifle on my scale comes in at 6.1 pounds. So very lightweight, very handy rifle overall. I like it because, again, it's not front heavy. That really is something that sort of I just don't like in rifles. And this beats that build just fine. The price point on this one, as you see it configured here, of course, with those Endless Pro sights, would be $1,549 over at Sionics website. That's their standard price. You guys can go over there and check that out. They have a few options to sort of upgrade and change things around. And one cool thing about Sionics is that if you call their office, like, a human being picks up, right? So that's an interesting thing. And if you wanted to customize it a little bit, I would imagine they would let you guys go with that. I don't want to write checks for Sionics that I can't cash, but from everything I've read, that seems to be the case. They will work with you and build the rifle for you. So there's that. And one thing, speaking of calling Sionics, I actually talked to the owner when I called over there, which was cool, and just about how they go into selecting components and things like that for their rifles. And of course, like I mentioned earlier, a lot of law enforcement use, and the owner mentioned that the thing that he thinks about when selecting that was, for instance, if you wanted to pick the takedown pin or you know, some of the lower receiver parts or something like that, if the option for him was to make, you know, an additional $5 margin, or to know that no matter what, that officer, or in this case civilian, could depend on that rifle to save their life, then he's gonna by all means skip the $5 an extra margin and pick the part that you know you can depend on. And that's an awesome thing. That's kind of the answer that I look for from all the different companies, but unfortunately that's not always the case, and it's not always what people want either out there in the market. Some people want a $600 gun, and that's cool. I review them, and you guys have seen it here, but if you guys want a rifle that's, you know, a fighting rifle, then Sionics, in my opinion, my experience from everything I've seen with this rifle and reading forums and stuff like that over the years, seem to be in that category by all means. This rifle here has had a grand total of zero malfunctions of any kind. It just keeps on running. When I got it in, cleaned it, lubricated it, and put over 800 rounds through it since with zero issues. That's not an extreme, you know, test of any kinds, but I'm very confident in it. And one question I want to cover, because I've released on social media several videos of this rifle, and I have a new high-speed camera for those that haven't noticed, and people remark on the barrel whip. That's completely normal for a lightweight profile, free-floated barrel. So I just want to point that out there. That's not anything abnormal at all about this barrel. It is properly stress-relieved. It's just kind of a cool effect that I'm able to capture now that I wasn't able to before. I think that pretty much covers it. If you guys have any questions about the rifle, by all means, you can post down below in the comment section. I'll also post a link over to the Sionics website so you guys can ask them, because certainly they're the subject matter experts on this rifle. I'm not just an end user. So you can also post those questions over at my Facebook page, which generally speaking is the best way to get in touch with me. And I think that should pretty much do it. Thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for subscribing. And I hope to see you back here for the next video.